Cycling is not new to Nigeria, as its history can be traced to the era of colonialism. Though cycling remains one of the oldest sports in Nigeria, it was initially seen as an avenue for recreation and physical fitness. However, in the early 70s, the story changed for the better as the coming into existence of the Cycling Federation of Nigeria in 1972 turned the tide. The new millennium came with greater fortunes for Nigerian cycling, as it has grown in leaps and bounds and has now become a promotional and award-winning sport in the country.
It was not so popular. If you see around now, you see a lot of store that is selling bike that before you have not seen. So it's meaning that they are picking up. Even ministry now, they are seeing the importance of this, because as I say, as activity is environmental friendly. Is associated with health benefit, very big health benefit for everybody. Cycling is a sport, is an activity that you can do from a very tender age to the very advanced one.
Nigeria took a huge step towards making her presence felt on the continent by making their debut at the African Continental Championship that was held in Sharm el-Sheikh in Egypt in 2013. They made their maiden appearance memorable by winning silver in the elite women's team time trial. Ever since, it has been a story of glory to glory for Nigerian cycling. In 2015 All African Games in Congo, there was gold for Team Nigeria, while the country also claimed silver in the individual event. Eight cyclists, made up of four males and four females, represented the country at the 2017 edition of the African Road Championship in Egypt, with Jacinta Okorie winning bronze. Team Nigeria also won medals at the 2017 African Continental Track Championships in KwaZulu-Natal, South Africa. 2018 will go down in history as a year in which the Cycling Federation of Nigeria attained greater heights. Nigeria's Abaka Kurotini won the maiden edition of the West Africa King of Mountain Race in Kwawu, Ghana, beating home favorite Solomon Tago and Burkina Faso's Gwimde Arnold to the top prize. The Cycling Federation of Nigeria also joined other countries of the world to make history by celebrating the first United Nations World Bicycle Day in June 2018. In July 2018, Team Nigeria participated in the cycling event of the 2018 Africa Youth Games in Algiers. The cyclists impressed at the games and had two silver medals in individual and team events to show for it. Team Nigeria cyclists also competed at the African Championships in Rwanda and African Track Championships in Morocco. With Nigerian cyclists gradually claiming their pride of place in Africa, the next hurdle for them to cross was the intercontinental barrier. The high point of the year for Nigerian cycling came when the Cycling Federation of Nigeria sponsored Nigeria's elite girls to the 2018 Giro delle Marche, which held in Italy from September 12 to 14. At the tour, which was the first global appearance, the Nigerian delegation showed no signs of being debutants, as their performance at the three-stage championship caught the eye of the cycling world.
Everybody was calling this Nigerian team, the way nobody could have expected that such team exists, and they can perform in that way.
It's a great opportunity for us, and it's a tough race for us. We did our best in the flats.
You know, we've been watching on TV and the rest are watching races, but this one we participated and we saw where we were and what next to do.
With this trip, at least they know their position and they are training hard more and more to defend their medal.
After the tour in Italy came the Congress of the International Cycling Union, UCI. There were positives at the Congress for Nigeria and Africa at large, with some international cycling events coming to the continent. As a way of ensuring that, cycling coaches in Nigeria acquaint themselves with the latest innovations and techniques in cycling, The Cycling Federation of Nigeria organized a coaching course for 25 coaches from various states of the country, with the instructor being Jean-Pierre Van Zyl, a UCI coach from South Africa.
I really think that they are on the level. Nigerian athletes are some of the best athletes in Africa, especially the women. We know that they won the All Africa Games in 2015, so it's very important for us to make sure that they are on a good level going forward, and that we aim to qualify for the Olympic Games.
In November 2018, Nigeria joined about 20 other African countries to compete at the maiden edition of the African Cycling Cup in Eritrea, after the event was approved by the International Cycling Union in September 2018. The sound preparation the team had prior to the championship really paid off, as Team Nigeria did not disappoint in Eritrea. The team gave good account of themselves and again made the headlines as they returned to the country with the gold and silver in the female category of the road race.
African Cup mean a lot, so much to us, for us to bring back the trophy.
We came back with something, you know, with the effort from the team, the coach, the coaching crew, the engineer. We all had to spread ourselves during races.
Anything he told us to do, we are always doing it. So that is why the thing come to pass and we bring out this trophy.
I'm proud of the girls. They did what they are supposed to do to make our country proud.
As a way of ensuring its road commissioners are abreast with the latest trends and updates at the sport, the Cycling Federation of Nigeria organized a course for national road commissioners in December 2018.
We were able to be enlightened and then being able to know the rules and regulations and how to really manage the stress around the commissioner.
They also included the updated rules, which we didn't know before. So it's actually very important for us.
The Cycling Federation of Nigeria ended a wait of about 4 years, in which Nigerian cyclists were unable to use the velodrome for high performance training and other cycling events. What now remains is for the velodrome to be certified. Nigerian cyclists began the year 2019 on a high as Team Nigeria finished the Africa Continental Championship in South Africa in January, with a total of 7 medals consisting of 5 silver and 2 bronze medals. The achievement, which drew commendation from the Confederation of African Cycling, shows that Nigeria is fast making headway in track cycling. Another recognition came for Nigerian cycling when the Confederation of African Cycling, CAC, decided to award Nigeria the hosting rights for the first ever Africa Cup Track Championship during the CAC AUC Congress in Rome, Italy, on the 11th of March 2019. In readiness for the championship, which was to come in July 2019, the Cycling Federation of Nigeria organized a 2-week training course for track cyclists in April 2019, with 90 athletes from different parts of Nigeria joined by their counterparts from Ghana and Benin Republic. An introductory course for Nigerian track commissaires and coaches was also embedded. The Confederation of African Cycling also provided the platform for coaches and commissaires to undergo a more intensive training from the 13th to the 24th of July 2019 in Abuja. The coaching course, which was in level 1 and level 2, lasted 4 days for coaches and 3 days for commissaires, with successful participants getting their certification at the end. Cyclists from different African countries also benefited from the training course for track cycling, which was part of the 3-in-1 event. Nigeria made history by hosting the first edition of Africa Cycling Cup Track in Abuja from 26th to 28th July 2019. The event, which was the first ever cycling competition to be held at the velodrome of the Abuja National Stadium, was won by Team Nigeria, who claimed 21 gold, 18 silver and 12 bronze medals to beat other participating nations.
Africa now for cycling is great. Africa now in cycling is very high. Also, I would like to congratulate the Nigerian riders. They got many gold medals today.
Cycling in Nigeria was very low. We were not a force to reckon with. But now, seeing our cyclists winning medals, not just medals, winning the gold medals of the tournament against a very strong nation, Egypt, shows that a lot has been accomplished.
For Africa, it's huge to have this first edition of the Africa Track Cup Series. We've got a dream in Africa. We want more riders to compete internationally on the world stage at World Championships and Olympic Games.
Following their success at the African Cycling Cup track, Nigeria made history again by featuring at the World Cycling Championship for the first time ever after the president, Cycling Federation of Nigeria, Gian Domenico Massari, led four male and four female cyclists to the 2019 World Junior Cycling Track Championship in Germany, which ran from 14th to 18th August. Joined by one coach and a mechanic, Team Nigeria, despite having a short time to train and prepare, still shocked the world as they surpassed the expectations of many at the event, which had 44 participating countries, including three from Africa.
Even though we didn't win anything, but at least all the time that we've been doing at home, we caught everything. Our time was very close to theirs.
We had to learn so many things, get some experiences, some riding patterns, how they do their things, and it was a great education for us.
The Cycling Federation of Nigeria, in its bid to ensure constant training of Nigerian coaches and encourage the participation of more women in coaching, organized a Level 2 UCI certified coaching course, which ran from the 10th to 14th December 2019. After that was the first of its kind Level 1 mechanic course, which was aimed at grooming more mechanics for the Federation with special emphasis on women. The UCI certified course, which held from 15th to 18th December 2019, thus provided the opportunity for the Federation to put an end to the era of having just one mechanic.
I am really happy with the level that the guys are showing here, and yeah, next is day that they need to continue practice.
Ahead of the 2020 Africa Track Championship, five Nigerian cyclists participated in the World Cycling Center training in South Africa from the 10th to 28th December 2019. Upon returning to the country, the cyclists continued their training from 29th December 2019 to 13th January 2020 in preparation for the 2020 African Track Championship.
We've been preparing, the president has been trying his best, sent us to South Africa for UCI training camp, and we're here again getting prepared for Cairo. So I think by God's grace we'll do our best.
It's going to be a little challenging, but I think I have to do my best. I'm promising maybe two gold medals for my own event.
Having had the best of trainings, 10 Nigerian cyclists made up of 4 male and 6 female participated at the 2020 African Track Championship in Cairo, Egypt, from January 14 to 20. It was a good outing for Team Nigeria, who were only making their second appearance at the championship as they won 11 medals, made up of 4 gold, 3 silver and 4 bronze, which saw them finish third on the overall medals table, with only South Africa and host Egypt finishing ahead of Nigeria at the championship, which had 10 participating countries. The team returned to the country with smiles on their faces, just as they revealed their desire to do more next time.
That event, I was very happy because even though it was in the senior game, it was in the senior game, I was very happy.
Now we have, of course, start working tirelessly to even consolidate what we have achieved, but even to make it better.
We have seen now that we need to be going for competitions and more training. We need to camping them, keep them together because they're coming to different places.
2020, which looked promising, suddenly became a challenging one, especially for the sports fraternity, with the cycling world not exempted. The coronavirus pandemic disrupted the sporting calendar, including that of the Cycling Federation of Nigeria. Despite the challenges, CFN stood tall among sports federations as they raised awareness on safety during the pandemic with messages like this. The year 2021 began on a good note for the Federation as Nigerian cyclists took the Africa Cycling Championship, having trained endlessly for about a month, gave good account of themselves in Cairo, Egypt. Nigeria won a total of 12 medals, made up of 2 gold, 6 silver and 4 bronze medals, to finish 4th on the medals table, only behind Egypt, South Africa and Algeria. Good became better for Nigerian cycling as the president, Engineer Gian Domenico Massari, became a voting delegate of the International Cycling Union, UCI, at the Confederation of African Cycling, CAC, elections. CFN Technical Director Bashir Mohammed was appointed Secretary General of CAC, while he also emerged a member of CAC Management Committee. Their new positions in the respective important organizations of cycling will no doubt have a positive impact on the development of cycling in Nigeria. One of the proudest moments for Nigerian cycling and cyclists came in June 2021 as the UCI rankings for May 2021 were released, with Nigeria making it to the top 3 in 5 different categories of the rankings. Nigeria ranked 2nd in the nation ranking for men's junior sprint, just behind South Africa, while the country also placed 3rd in the ranking for men's junior 1 km time trial. In the women's category, Nigeria ranked 3rd behind Russia and Germany in junior sprint. The country placed 2nd in women's junior time trial and also retained 2nd spot in the junior team sprint. The icing on the cake was Nigeria placing 1st in Africa and 6th in the world in the women's elite team sprint ranking. Nigeria was also 1st in Africa and 7th in the world in the women's elite team pursuit, while in the women's elite time trial, Nigeria ranked 1st in Africa and 9th in the world. A further breakdown of Nigeria's UCI rankings shows the level of progress made in the past few years. In the women's elite category, Nigeria has moved from being ranked outside the top 30 in about 15 race types to being in the top 30 in the world, whilst ranking among the top 10 in 500 meters time trial, 3 km pursuit, team sprint and team pursuit. In the junior category for women, tremendous progress has been made, with Nigeria ranked among the top 8 in different race types, while being ranked 3rd in junior sprint, 2nd in junior time trial, and also 2nd in team sprint ranking. A positive increase has also been recorded in UCI rankings for Nigeria in the men's junior category, with the country previously ranked outside the top 17 in the world, now ranked among the top 10 in 8 different race types, with Nigeria 3rd in the 1 km time trial ranking. With a target of appearing for the first time at the Olympics in 2024, the Federation, shortly after the Tokyo 2020 Olympics, rolled out their qualification plans by inviting the cyclists to camp for about 1 month and then proceeding to enter them to participate in 2 international competitions which would help them garner points. The first was the UCI Junior Track Cycling World Championships in Cairo, Egypt, from September 1 to 5, 2021. 11 cyclists left Nigeria to meet up with 4 others who were camping in Egypt. Team Nigeria, represented by 15 cyclists, joined 46 other participating countries for the championship, which saw 237 cyclists compete in 22 events. And then, from the 9th to 12th September 2021, four female elite cyclists also represented Nigeria at the UCI Nations Cup in Cali, Colombia, with the competition also serving as pre-qualification for the Paris 2024 Olympics.
When you are talking in a world event, you know, the level is quite very, very high. So you can't expect to achieve this. But what is important, participate, expose our athlete to all these type of techniques, all these type of, you know, procedure that they will be held there. Moreover, let know that Nigeria is there.
Following the success of the 2019 African Track Cycling Championship hosted by Nigeria, the country was again given the hosting rights for the 2022 edition of the championship to be held in Abuja in July 2022. The signing ceremony for the hosting rights was in Brussels on 24th September 2021 with UCI President David Lapartion in attendance alongside UCI Vice President and CAC President Dr. Azam Wageo and the President of the Cycling Federation of Nigeria, Gian Domenico Masari. Team Nigeria hit another landmark on the world stage in October 2021 as they made their debut at the UCI Track Cycling World Championships in France with four cyclists representing the country. Nigerian cyclists, despite appearing at the championships for the first time, went ahead to garner points which will aid their quest to qualify for the Paris 2024 Olympics. In another feather to the team's cap at the championships, Nigeria's new kit was rated the best, with the skin suit design attracting a lot of commendations. The UCI rankings also came with some good news for Team Nigeria as they moved from 8th to 6th in the Women's Elite 500 meters time trial. In the Women's Elite Team Sprint, the country moved from 10th in the world to 5th, while in the Women's Elite Team Pursuit, it was from 14th position to 7th. There was also rise for Nigeria in the Women's Elite Keirin, Women's Elite Omnium, Women's Elite Points Race, and the Women's Elite Scratch. From the 21st to 24th April 2022, Nigeria participated in the Track Nations Championship in Glasgow, Scotland, with the renowned Italian coach Vincenzo Cerci conducting training for the teaming camp for about 2 months before the competition. On the 4th of June, Nigerian cyclists began camping for the Africa Track Cycling Championship being hosted for the first time in Nigeria. The Confederation of African Cycling also organized a training camp for cyclists from all participating countries, including Nigeria, from the 4th to 12th July 2022. CAC then organized courses for mechanics and level 2 coaches from the 9th to 13th July, with Nigeria and other countries participating. The championship, which held from 14th to 17th July, was a huge success, with the Cycling Federation of Nigeria putting up a good show as hosts. Nigerian cyclists returned to camp in the first week of September, following their qualification for the World Track Championship in Paris, where they made their appearance in the competition, which held from 12th to 16th October 2022. Team Nigeria participated in 6 events of Team Pursuit, Team Sprint, Elimination, 500-meter sprint, 250-meter sprint, and time trial, as they bid to be in a good position to qualify for the cycling event of the Paris 2024 Olympics. The year 2023 began on a high for cycling in Nigeria as the country, for the first time, qualified for the Olympic Games with leading female cyclist and National Sports Festival champion Ese Operesaye sealing qualification to the 23rd Olympics in Paris in 2024 after hitting the mandatory 250 points at the CAC Road Championship
held in Accra, Ghana from February 8 to 13. Nigeria won 4 medals, made up of 3 gold and 1 silver at the championship. Nigeria also made history by competing for the first time in the Africa Paracycling Championship from 15th to 18th February in Ghana, winning 2 medals of 1 gold and 1 silver in the big class tender. Looking to make sure that more cyclists make the qualification for the Olympics and other world events, 8 female cyclists, comprising 6 elite and 2 juniors, competed at the Africa Track Championship, while 4 female elite participated in the UCI Nations Cup held in Cairo, Egypt. A total of 11 medals, comprising 2 gold, 2 silver and 7 bronze, were won at the Africa Track Championship, with the 2 gold medals coming in the female elite time trial and junior point race. Having successfully completed the UCI Nations Cup in Cairo, Team Nigeria secured qualification for the Road World Championship for both the elite and junior, as well as the World Track Championship in Glasgow in August 2023. In promoting cycling in Nigeria, the Federation, in partnership with the Rivers State Government, put together a National Cycling Road Championship on Sunday, 21st May 2023. Talents were discovered at the event, with CFN President appreciating the state governor for his contribution to the success of the event. In a bid to see more Nigerian cyclists qualify for Paris 2024 Olympics, the Federation ensured more cyclists participated in international competitions. On 1st August 2023, Team Nigeria cyclists, comprising 5 female and 2 male, departed Abuja, Nigeria to Glasgow, Scotland to participate in the 2023 UCI World Championships, while the junior female team on 2nd August 2023 departed to Trinidad and Tobago for the 7th Commonwealth Youth Games, which held from 4th to 11th August 2023. Both teams did the country proud even in the paracycling event at Glasgow, which Nigeria participated for the very first time. Worthy of note is the help the country got to aid the team in their participation, as the Nigeria female team were presented 5 high-quality road bicycles, 3 which came from the Italian team, 1 from Specialized and 1 from the World team, through the support of former World Road Champion Alessandra Cappellotto, who was duly appreciated by CFN President for her endless support to the Federation. Meanwhile, more support is coming for the Federation internationally. Recently, renowned manufacturers Rodi Project presented the cyclist 10 road and 4 track helmets, while world-leading Italian protective sportswear manufacturers Sidi donated customized riding shoes, with both items designed in Nigerian colors. As the Cycling Federation of Nigeria continues to focus on the development of the sport in Nigeria, funding has proven to be a challenge.
We are showing that cycling is one of the most important sports, and they're giving result, not only locally but internationally. So now we are really in a very serious sponsorship driving to raise interest among sponsors, that investing in cycling is investing in people, is investing in even environment, in investing in a lot of things that can be better the society and can give a lot of opportunity to many people.
Looking back, the Cycling Federation of Nigeria has covered lots of grounds within a short period, and the Federation is ready to attain more enviable heights in no distant future.